Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. On the SSGI graph, we look at magnitude 5.5 and larger earthquakes against the planetary and lunar geometry. And we see the cluster that occurred on the 1st of October. I explained that in the previous update. And I anticipated possible larger seismic activity following the lunar geometry on 4-5 October. And so far, we only have a 5.6 actually following the lunar conjunction with Uranus that happened yesterday night. And additional stronger seismic activity may occur later today, tomorrow. We often see these larger earthquakes in clusters. So no larger earthquake. And that begs the question, where are the magnitude 7 earthquakes? Well, I cannot say that we are really in a magnitude 7 earthquake drought. That's not the case. Although the last time that a magnitude 7 earthquake occurred, that was on August 17th. And that is close to 2 months ago, whereas the average is 24 days. So we could say that we are due for a magnitude 7 earthquake. Now, interestingly, if we look at the larger magnitude 7 earthquakes, and we specifically 7.6 and larger, we have to actually go back to May 2023, the last time that was on May 19th at the southeast of Loyalty Islands. That was a 7.7, and 7.6 at Tonga was also on May 10th in 2023. If we look at 7.8 and larger, we really have to go back to central Turkey, and that was in February 2023. If we look at magnitude 8 earthquakes, we all have to go back all the way to August 2021. Now, it is not really unusual. We have seen earthquake droughts of magnitude 8 earthquakes up to 4 years. So it may take another year for a magnitude 8 earthquake to occur. I mentioned these large earthquakes because if we look at the next time frame, at the SGI graph from the 7th of October until the 16th, we initially don't see all that much. We have Mercury, Venus, Neptune, and Venus, Mercury, Neptune in semi-right angle geometry, and there may be some seismic response there, clustering of stronger earthquakes also because of the lunar conjunctions as Moon, Earth, Jupiter, and Moon, Earth, Mars. But we look at the end of this time frame, and that's specifically on the 14th and 15th. There we see the notorious right angle geometry of Mercury, Venus, and Uranus. And I will do a very, very detailed analysis of that geometry in the next update, but I will give you some idea already here. That specific geometry comes along maybe 2-3 times a year, and this is actually the third time. Now, if you look just at 2024, the previous 2 times that that geometry appeared, we had magnitude 7 earthquake within 5 days. That was in Taiwan, 7.4, within 5 days of that particular planetary geometry. And also on in August, 2-4 August, we had this kind of geometry, and we had a magnitude 7.1 earthquake in Japan within 4 days. So we can go back to 2023, and we see similar statistics. This geometry is very, very critical. And this time, it's going to converge with planetary conjunctions, also involving Mercury and Venus. If we look at the solar system here, we see the right angle geometry of Mercury and Venus. They are close to the Sun, whereas Uranus is far away. So within 1 or 2 days, both Mercury and Venus will make right angle geometry with Uranus. At the same time here, we see that Mercury, Sun, and Uranus will be in a conjunction, and that will be on the 15th. And we also see that Earth will be in a conjunction with Venus and Uranus. And this all happens on the 14th and 15th at the time of this critical, very critical right angle geometry. So I suspect that if there is the potential for mid to high 7, or larger earthquake, 16 to 20 October is definitely a candidate. But again, I will go into much more detail in the next update. I will include the statistics because this geometry is really serious. And we have to pay attention to this geometry, definitely. So again, as at the SGI graph, we see initially the geometry with the Moon and Mercury, Venus, Neptune. There may be some clustering there coming up from the 10th to the 11th, 12th I think 10th to the 11th, 10, 11 October, maybe the 9th already. There is the potential there for clustering of stronger earthquakes. I don't think it will be really much. But then starting on the 13th with right angle geometry, involves Venus, Mars and Saturn. I think that is the beginning of really critical, time. And, we could see a very, obvious seismic response as early as the 16th, in my opinion. Check out the website and the social media for the latest updates. Also, the atmospheric fluctuations. As always, we have dedicated channels on Facebook, on Telegram and on WhatsApp, whatever you prefer. This is the update for now. Until next time.